What's going on, everyone? Juice Bags here, and welcome back to some Dungeon Defenders 2. I've been getting a ton of questions about Chaos 8 Shards. As most of you know, the latest update has unlocked Chaos 8 Shards for sale at the vendor, and people want to know, what are the Chaos 8 Shards to get? What are the best ones out there? Now, first off, I gotta start off by saying, there is not a single Chaos 8 Shard that is going to bring as much to the table as what you're going to get out of the trifecta of shards. So destruction, deadly strikes, and defense rate are far more important than any single Chaos 8 shard available. Now with that in mind, of course, there are some Chaos 8 shards that really stand out. And remember, all of these shards are build dependent. If you're going exactly for a specific build, then some of these shards might be required. However, as far as just an overall gameplay experience, none of them are. You're going to be far better off just sticking with destruction, deadly strikes, and defense rate than any of these shards in the bunch. Now, taking a peek through, the Gun Witch gets lots of love in Chaos 8. You get Enduring Price, you get the Price of Power, you get several shards, minus the Ice Needle shard that never made it onto the interface. Not sure if that's a bug or if that was intended. However, the Gun Witch does get lots of love for specific builds through Chaos 8 shards. Power Overwhelming would be an absolutely incredible shard for any hero. However, as you see, it is usable only by the Abyss Lord. Now, if you're going for an Ability Power Abyss Lord build, Power Overwhelming is definitely a shard you're going to want to go for. Taking a look through the rest, Oily Harpoons is more of a novelty shard. However, if you want your ballistas to oil, then Oily Harpoon is the way you're going to get it. We go into Price of Power for the Gun Witch. Enduring Bubble, in theory, is a great shard. However, with walls not really being included in the meta, it doesn't really stand out. It's not one that you're just going to need. Now, Lightning Touch is actually a little bit disappointing. Your primary attacks have a chance to do additional damage of storm damage. In my opinion, this one is not really worth a shard slot if you're completely up in the air and you just don't know what shard to plug in and you have this shard. You will get small benefit from it if you're focusing on a hero damage type primary attack build. However, this is not a shard that's going to give you a massive increase in damage overall. Power of Embermount, same thing there. It's not really a shard that's going to bring a whole lot of gameplay changes into it. You got Proton Cannon Boost, the width of proton charge increased by 100%. It's actually debatable if this shard does anything at all, so certainly not necessary. Proton Flame Charge, however, is a raw damage increase. If you want to do a Proton Charge Ability Power EV2 build, the Proton Flame Charge is definitely a hot item to go for. However, certainly not required in any build. Regeneration is just straight up disappointing. This used to be an extremely overpowered shard and is one of the shards, in my opinion, that I think caused the removal of all of these Chaos 8 shards from the game, as it was so ridiculously overpowered in the past. Now, however, it is tamed down to practically nothing. The benefit there is it is a boot shard, so if you have an empty shard slot and just nothing else to go in it, why not throw some regeneration in there? However, nothing really spectacular. Now, jumping right on through, a lot of these are just completely novelty shards. Pumpkinator, Snakes on the Plain, not really necessary. Serpent's God Fury can be really good as well. Anytime your primary attacks crit, it's going to lower the cooldown of your abilities. So if you get 10 crits, it's going to lower those cooldowns right down just at 0 of 18. Now, obviously, if you upgrade this further, you're going to get the full benefits. Submerging Speed is how the Lava Mancer gets to go super duper fast. Radiant Power, now this one is kind of interesting. This is another shard that used to be just extremely powerful. Right now, the only situation it would really be overly useful is for a melee hero that's going to be fighting inside of auras. So if you like to build with ground traps, auras, and nodes, and you like to play melee and get up in the lane, then yeah, Radiant Power is going to give you a buff to your defenses in the area there. Now, Shattering Torpedo by itself is not a remarkable shard. However, if you're going for the Reflect Beam Petrify build, Shattering Torpedo is indeed what you're going to want to use. Spider's Kiss is a little bit underwhelming, and Sundering Blow is another one of the shards that could be very good on any melee hero. So if you're playing melee, Sundering Blow could be a good shard for you. Superconductor reduces the cost of all your abilities by 1%. I mean, this could go with any ability power user. If you're an ability power user, Superconductor could definitely be nice for you, as it's going to lower the cost of all of your abilities overall. Torpedo Striker is like getting an additional Deadly Strikes. Now, sadly, Deadly Strikes compares or scales terribly on a Reflect Beam. The Reflect Beam is really going to scale best with Vicious Strikes. Vicious Strikes, of course, being that Hyper Shard, and it will take the Reflect Beam to the max explosion radius. Torpedo Striker is just one of those that you're just really not going to need. Wave of the Storm is another shard, another one of those boot shards that are not 100% useful. It's something. If you don't have a shard to go into your boot slots, throw a Wave in the Storm in there. It's certainly not going to hurt anything, but on the same note, you're not going to be changing your game based off of that shard. Taser Suit could actually be an absolutely incredible shard, but it is proc-based, meaning it's a chance of this going off when you're attacked. For me personally, I have terrible luck. It never goes off when I really need it to, like with an assassin or whatever. It does proc. It procs all the time. It just never procs when I really, really needed it to proc. And that's kind of my problem with Taser Suit. I do use it still on several heroes. However, it's one that I wouldn't really go out of my way overall to pick up. Vengeance is another one of those blockade shards that without having some sort of a blockade meta or more useful blockades, this shard is going to go without needing in any way whatsoever. Tempered Anger is really good if you play actively on the Mystic. As everyone knows, when your appeasement drains on the Mystic, you start taking damage. This eliminates that damage taken, so it's a nice shard to have. It does take up a chest shard slot, which there are plenty of valuable shards out there. However, Tempered Anger is one that I personally use. There's nothing wrong with appeasement draining slower and then taking no damage if you do bottom out and hit zero. Now, Water Elemental is another one of those build-specific and dependent shards. If you're trying to get your tower to drench, Water Elemental is a hot item. Situation would be, say, like the current weapon manufacturers. If you've got Shocking Revelations on your Weapon Mans as a mod, you can use the Water Elemental Shard and create a self-procking Electrocute combo. Now, once again, this is also a chance on hit, so it's not guaranteed that it's going to go off and drench the enemies. However, it is a way for you to get it done if you're looking for that specific build. So basically, overall, although there are some nice enticing shards in the Chaos 8 packs, none of these shards are really going to change your game. They're certainly not going to change your game anywhere near as much as that big trifecta that I mentioned. Destruction, Deadly Strikes, and Defense Rate are really the go-to shards. If I personally was to recommend spending Defender Medals or Gems on any particular shard, it would without a doubt be one of those three. So Destruction, Defense Rate, Deadly Strikes for the win. Everything else is going to be a novelty or something that you don't specifically need that exact shard to progress through the game. So hopefully this helps answer some questions. If anyone's got any comments, make sure you let me know down below. And if there's any questions out there, throw them down there as well, and I'll do my best to get them answered for you. So thank you all so much for watching. Make sure to click that like button. Please subscribe to the channel. And I will be back soon with some more Dungeon Defenders 2. I'll see you next time.